I'm Petri Talilay, and I come from Kosovo. I live in Berlin, but also in Italy and Kosovo. I bring here a kind of a conversation and a discoveries through people and objects that brought me to kind of in two levels. One is that through a moth and insect collection that I found by chance in 2009, discovering the whole lost collection of Natural History Museum, which was replaced after the war by the Kosovo and government and the museum, giving priority to new national identity and replacing it with ethnological museum. And then through this, the same collection, which after 2 years, the only way to have it was by organizing myself to steal it. Through my mom, we started a conversation about a memory that I don't have, or I have no image about it, which is about me being much more feminine and wanting to spend time with chickens, moths. And one of the things was in connection to the moths, that if I would see a moth going around the bulb, whoever was in a room would have to help me to catch it, otherwise I would cry crazy. And also telling me that only by starting the school and education I became different, and this was the conversation when they didn't know yet that I was gay, and a lot of things of who really I am, which they didn't know that, because before I would know even, and I don't remember when I started, but apparently I knew how to hide it very well, which is my identity. And this idea of you that hide someone who you are, that is so essential to you, and that so this was in personal way, but in a collective way, that we decide to hide the whole museum of natural history to replace it with ethnologic museum. And I thought there was some similar attitudes that were repeated in these two extremes inside of a society, and I couldn't not react on that. To me, it's this kind of bringing these conversations that make shapes to these costumes, or let's say performative sculptures, that are all potentially possible to be activated, and they are made in my body size. So as I can enter and become a moth and transform kind of in an insect, and this idea that they are made with a carpet that reflects and brings back to this lost museum, and transformed a carpet in the wings and something natural, also combined with the presence of a different light. So I decided to don't use the biennial light, and I brought more of these bulbs that are something definitely from that comes from a more domestic context, but also the bulb in this context is flickering, which is kind of changing of positions of what a moth would do if they would feel a presence of a human being or so. And I like this idea that most of people, like, maybe will lose a very important part of the work up, but it's also how I see life in a way, like that we lose things, we miss things, and that's what bring kind of this magic on it somehow. I was very happy to discover and see more works from Maria Lai in beginning, and I would end it with the Hasan Khan at the end in the garden, very end. And I'm so happy to see that the Pavilion of Kosovo, which this year is the third time we are part of the biennial. In general, I think, you know, it's very hard when you are part of a biennial to make an opinion in 2 days, because you are so much into sharing what you already did since so long, and you are finally presenting and sharing with friends and everyone. But I can say that there is some a very subtle human gestures through when you walk through that brings a certain point of view and hope, and constructive hope in a way, that I really appreciate, and I feel so much happy to be part of it.